Tea.
Good morning, Oxford! Who is ready for a brew?
Us Brits love a brew. We consume a committed 165 million cups every day. But how do we like it? I'm taking to the streets of Oxford to find out.
Do you like it in a mug or a paper cup?
Undoubtedly in the mug.
Mug, definitely.
I don't like tea out of a paper cup at all.
Why do you prefer to drink tea out of a mug? I think this keeps it warm and hot for longer.
I would say a mug definitely holds temperature better.
I don't really know, it just doesn't taste the same.
It's the grip, you see.
Oh, it's the grip.
In Oxford, at least, the mug takes it. But why? I need some help from two different faculties from one of the world's leading universities. Meet psychologist Charles Spence and physicist Stephen Blundell.
Stephen!
Hello.
Charles! Now, lots of people said that they prefer it from a mug because the mug keeps it hotter and they like hot tea.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Well, let's try adding some hot water to these cups of tea.
Is going to show me which cup is more efficient at holding heat by measuring the surface temperature of the two teas.
We can do that using a thermal imaging camera. So we can measure the surface of the water here, and you can see it's about 70 degrees in the porcelain cup.
That is red hot, isn't it?
But it's distinctly warmer in the paper cup. It's more like 77 degrees. So the tea is cooling much faster in this cup than in the paper cup.
That is very surprising. That is quite a difference, isn't it?
This is because the paper cup contains lots of layers with some air gaps, so it's a very good insulator, a little bit like wearing a jumper. Whereas the porcelain cup is cooling down a bit faster.
So, Charles, if it isn't about temperature, then what is it?
Well, it's all got to be a matter of psychology. It's all about what's going on in the head of the person who's doing the tasting. I think what we feel in our hands can have as much influence as the contents of the cup or the mug in determining what we think we taste.
So do you genuinely believe that tea tastes different from a mug than it does from a paper cup?
Absolutely.
Charles has devised an experiment to determine what's going on.
What we would love you all to do is a drink, a tea from table A and table B.
The participants are then asked to vote for which one they prefer.
How does that one compare?
I prefer the other one. This one tastes a bit, well, smells a bit more bland.
How is that brew?
Yeah, I preferred the first one. It was a bit sweeter, a bit more aroma to it. I thought the second one was a bit bland.
TB or not TB? In fact, all participants chose TA as their favourite.
So looking at those results, is it pretty much the case that did everyone in the room think that they were drinking two types of different tea? Were they, Charles?
No, in fact, the tea was exactly the same.
So, Charles, if it was exactly the same tea in each of the cups, what was the difference?
And the difference was that one of those two cups had a small 30-gram weight added underneath.
Secret little weight underneath. Look at that, cheeky Charles. Why can the vessel from which you drink affect the results so drastically?
Yeah, people can't separate the drink from the container. It's almost as if, you know, your brain takes that weight as a sign of quality, which in many categories it is. And that's equally true here for tea as it is for anything else.
Well, guys, I don't know how you feel. I feel like a bit of a mug. I don't know about you lot.